Okay, Hal. Monitor Sports is brought to you by Reader's Digest, with more than 40 articles and features of current and lasting interest. In one moment, a baseball bridge with the past. But first, this word from Reader's Digest.
The trouble is they still treat me like a child. Sure, teachers, parents, everybody. They don't catch on. They're kind of stupid about it, if you ask me. I get sore about it sometimes.
Adolescents have many problems, and so do their parents. Read Why Adolescents Act That Way in March Reader's Digest. This digest article reveals in detail the mysterious inner developments that transform a child into an adult. It describes how an entirely new person is born during the process of adolescence. Learn why even a slight criticism at this time is likely to bring a reaction of rage.
I don't claim I'm always right, but they nag, nag, nag. I'm not a kid anymore. I got rights.
Why does a happy-go-lucky youngster become a troubled, rebellious semi-adult? If you want to understand young people better, girls as well as boys, be sure to read Why Adolescents Act That Way, one of more than 40 articles and features from leading magazines and books, condensed to save you time in March Reader's Digest, now on sale.
This is Mel Allen again. Friends, one of the greatest of all Detroit pitchers, Tommy Bridges, recently left the Tiger organization to devote full time to his tire business in Lakeland, Florida. Tommy, if you'll recall, put together three consecutive 20-game seasons back in the 30s and won, 194 games in all. What a curveball he had. Oh, he had a great one. And with the Grapefruit League now active, what else besides baseball would Tommy Bridges be talking about to Monitor reporter Cliff Evans?
Tommy Bridges, it's nice catching up with you, but I'm a little surprised. I remember watching you play ball years ago, and when you were pitching, you looked awfully short. Now, how tall are you?
I'm 5'11", Cliff.
Well, I wonder whether I'm the only one who remembers you as being on the short side.
Well, perhaps you saw me on some bad days when I was extremely short out there.
Well, those bad days are awfully rare. Tommy Bridges, you pitched those very same Detroit Tigers to several championships. There was 1934 and 35 and 1940 and then into the service and back for the tail end of the 45 season. And you played on the same team with Mickey Cochran and Hank Greenberg and Charlie Gehringer, all now in the Hall of Fame. Now, what was Hank Greenberg like in those days as a player?
Hank was one of the hardest workers I ever saw in my life, and as you just mentioned, he is now in the Hall of Fame, as the other two fellows you mentioned, and that's a good indication that that great determination he had certainly paid off. He was a great home run hitter, and I'd like to add here that Hank Greenberg, in my books, is really a swell guy.
Well, Tommy, I was wondering, when you say a hard worker, just how does a baseball player work hard, or work harder than any other player?
Well, I guess, Cliff, it didn't come extremely easy for Hank. There's a few things in the game that weren't exactly natural to him. And with his determination and desire to achieve success, he just simply bowed his neck, went to work, and learned to do those things. Hank worked on his faults. And believe me, when he got through working on them, there was very few left, if any at all.
No question about that. This is an all-time great. Now, another former teammate of yours, also in the Hall of Fame, what was he like, Mickey Cochran?
Well, Mickey, of course, showed us how to win. When he was catching, he came over from Philadelphia, which is one of the greatest breaks I think Detroit ever had. Great catcher and a great field leader. He inspired everybody, and he showed us how to take the ball and carry it, and we were a young ball club. And I guess you would say, Cliff, the records say that he did a very fine job. He's with the Tigers now, by the way.
Tommy, you say that Mickey Cochran inspired you fellows. Now, when you come up to the big leagues, you're all pros. What inspiration do you need?
The only way I know how to answer that, Cliff, is to say that Mickey had just a little bit more fire, more spark came off of him than anyone I've ever played ball with.
Tommy Bridges, it's always nice talking with you. This is Cliff Evans.